kitchen table of Silver Surf Wax. If it's your first time joining this video channel, I wanted to let you guys know it's primarily about gold and silver stacking, but one of the things that I had as a goal or desire for this channel is to be talking about prepping and other topics like hard money, such as Bitcoin, and things of this nature. So not just gold and silver, but some other topics that involve being prepared. And so with this coronavirus outbreak and the interest and concern in the community, a lot of gold and silver stackers are talking about these topics too. And of course, it's on my mind and a lot of other people's mind. I'm not going to go into the details about the coronavirus and the things that you need to know. Other channels are covering that, news organizations and the World Health Organization, the WHO, are covering that much better than I'm gonna do. I'm not a medical professional, so I'm not even gonna try in that regard. But one of the things I did want to do is talk about some practical prepping that I have done. And I wanted to, in future videos on the prepping, there's a lot of stuff that I've done for my family, for my house, in my life, to make sure that I've had some preps. And one of them has been related to pandemic stuff. So I wanted to at least show you that. It seems like a timely time to show that off, although I had hoped to do this in a little more organized fashion rather than sort of spur of the moment, but there's no time like the present. So I wanted to show you my pandemic box. It's a work in progress, but definitely wanted to give you some of the things that I've done for my house, and then you can kind of see how you might want to start going about things. And my kind of general rule for prepping is very incremental. Do the things that you can. Over a long period of time, there's no need to go out and rush and spend thousands of dollars, but over a good amount of time, you can develop quite a amount of preps. So I'm going to take you here out of the kitchen table, and we are going to head on down to the garage of Silver Surf Wax. So here we go. Here's the cards of Silver Surf Wax, and real quick, here's the water supply. This is the wall of preps here. I've got I got 3 months of emergency food for a family of four. I've got enough water to cook all of that food, and I've got enough fuel for some propane to fill up the to boil all of this water. So actually, I got probably triple the amount of fuel necessary. And over here, we got a lot of our camping gear, but I'm going to direct you to the pandemic box. So what I have done in my storage here is I have, let's move this to the side real quick, just so we'll talk about that in a second. What I've done here is I have stored the boxes of my N95 masks. So kind of the basic of, or the primary stack of this pandemic box. So these masks are the N95 masks. These are the antibacterial type of masks that you want to have. I'm gonna need to put this down for a second, so you're going to be looking at a blank screen real quick. But what I have done is I have purchased quite a few of these masks. So you notice that the N95 surgical masks here, these are the standard that you want to get to, or at least your first standard. And each box of these has 200 of them, and I have two boxes. So I actually have 400 single-use respirator masks. And the way that you want to use these things is pretty much, after, if you're in an area where there's infection, you don't want to touch the mask after you've used it. You want to take this thing off and dispose of it. And what you're going to want to do is actually try to have, not only for a pandemic environment, would you want this for waste objects, but you're going to want to, you know, have a biohazard bag that you can put biohazard waste into. So I have, in addition to the surgical masks, the N95, I have biohazard bags so that we can properly dispose of this and other, you know, human waste or other infected waste. And so, you know, bought a box, a big box of biohazard bags, bought boxes of N95 respirators, and in the biohazard or the pandemic box, I also have a bunch of plastic sheeting, a bunch of duct tape to be able to create sort of compartmentalize our rooms without that would help keep a barrier, air barrier, as well as you know, some respirators that cover the full face, and that you can use to replace these filters, as well as put in the biohazard filters. So yeah, bunches. I can't, you know, just show you how deep this is, but there's a bunch of plastic sheeting in there, and we got ourselves, you know, some water filtration. I have another box of stuff for water filtration, but I got a Life Straw in this one, and I've got some other water filtration. But the major part of my pandemic box is these masks, you know, so that one thing you're noticing right now is in China, these puppies are all sold out and Amazon is all sold out. So that, you know, people are rushing in to get these better masks. Now, if you go to Home Depot, you can get yourself some dust masks, right? Some just regular masks that are just going to help you filter dust, but they're not going to be this N95 standard that's going to be filtering biological viruses and things like this. So you can look this standard up, and a lot of other people are obviously talking about that. So having those in your pandemic box is something that I recommend, and it's something that I've done. And, you know, it's here with all my other preps and the things that I have in the sort of wall of survival here. So the next question would be is, where are my weaknesses? What don't I have yet? You know, and what am I growing and building towards in terms of my pandemic preparedness and just general overall preparedness? Well, while I do have a bunch of thin gloves and leather gloves and some rubber protective gloves that are kind of, you know, rubber around the finger area, but that's not necessarily on the back. I do have a lot of those kind of protective gloves, but I don't have thick hazmat gloves, and I don't have any hazmat suits, even painting suits or things like this, where I could outfit myself or my family with some sort of full body gear. And it's kind of taking it to the next level, but I think that's a reasonable thing to do, to just have in preparation. It may not cost that much. I also don't have full, you know, rubber boots for everybody. You know, I live in California and San Diego, and I'm not in a winter area. And so I don't have galoshes or things like this. It's just not something that we naturally would get. So I don't have sort of that full body preparedness. We do have snow gear, but, you know, not really sort of that hazmat kind of situation. The other thing that I noticed that I'm weak on is disinfectant bottles. I do have bleach. I have a couple bottles of bleach for disinfecting, but I don't have... I only have one spray bottle. I was kind of surprised. I was looking around like, where are all my spray bottles? I remember buying these things. So I need to go out and buy like four spray bottles so that I can set up a disinfectant kind of mudroom at the entrance to the house, which is really the garage, so that if there were a significant pandemic type of scenario, before entering the house, you can spray down with bleach and wipe down if you had rubber suits and things that you want to sort of disinfect from. And so that is kind of my weakness. And really, you know, just I'm pretty good. I feel like I have a 3 months of supplies for sheltering in place. And so, you know, like, but do you have enough to have a couple of weeks to a month to shelter in place? Do you have enough toilet paper? Do you not have enough for 3 months? Do you have enough food and fuel and water for 3 months? Do you have toothpaste and toiletries, contact lens solution? You know, are you living day to day? Do you need to go to the store every day? Or do you have enough supplies that can last you for a week, a month, 3 months? I've gotten up to the 3 months, but for a long time, I was down in the month range, and it took me a while. In fact, let me show you some of the supplies that I have that I've gotten up to the 3 months. It takes a little bit to get up to this level. So in each bathroom, I have gone ahead and installed a cabinet unit because I didn't have one before. And I installed the cabinet unit so that I could store the towels, but to have a deep stock of toilet paper and of tissue paper, as well as baby wipes up here. So I have three bathrooms in this house, and they all have this many towels, toilet paper, and tissue paper, and baby wipes. So plenty of stock of toiletries or paper products for at least a month or three. In addition to my other storage of my backup storage up in the laundry room of toilet paper that I'll restock these places with when they get low, and then I'll replenish and rotate out through the stock that I have in the active stock that I have in all of the bathrooms. So like I mentioned, in addition to the stock of toilet paper that I have in each bathroom, I also have sort of the deep storage, the rotating storage. So if any bathroom were happen to run out, I have storage up here. So bunches of tissue papers, Kleenex boxes, and then bunches of baby wipes and to clean and disinfect things, as well as bunches of toilet papers, big cases of toilet paper, as well as a ton of paper towels. Now downstairs, I have twice this amount in the cabinetry above the refrigerator that has paper towels. So I have paper towels till the cats come home. So just kind of illustrating here some of the deep storage and paper products that I have. This should last me at least 3 months. So there you saw all the toilet paper that I have. I also have paper towels, and my standard idea is that you have your operating stock, right? You have the thing that you're using, you know, is your operating stock for food is the stuff in your refrigerator and your pantry. But what is your rotating stock? What's your deep storage? You know, and that's maybe for food and water. That's my emergency stash of food and water. I might have water in the refrigerator, but I have a case of water in every car. And so I have water kind of stocked in the fridge in the car. Each car has a whole case of water, and then tons of water stored throughout, in the garage there. So the idea being, hey, you know, analyze your situation, look at what you're doing at your own home, and do you have just a little bit of sugar on hand, or do you have enough sugar to cook for a month? Are you getting rid of your supplies? Do you have enough storage in your cabinetry for deeper supplies? So those are the kind of thoughts that I'm having, and this is the kind of thing I wanted to go over in this video. Show off the pandemic box, be able to show off, having some of those mass filters. Other areas that I'm weak, I wish I had more air filtration, more HEPA air filtration. It's pretty expensive. So if you want to get a good air filtration system for each bedroom, you know, you're gonna drop some coin, and I don't have that yet. I have, you know, single amount of air filtration. So those are areas that I can improve and I'm looking to improve on in the future. All right, guys. Well, I just wanted to do this quick short video to be able to get out something as this coronavirus seems to be spreading as of today. We already have 2,000 infections and I forget, I think it was still less than 100 deaths, but this is clearly spreading. I just saw a case that has popped up in Orange County, which is only 60 miles away from me. So, you know, we've got multiple cases in the U.S. from people traveling from China. So this is getting kind of scary. Obviously, other viruses have spread in the same manner and we've contained it and it hasn't been as virulent. So there's, you know, not any need to panic right now, but, luck favors the prepared. So good luck to you all out there and hope you start getting yourself prepped. And again, like I said, slow but steady. You don't need to panic. You don't need to make rash decisions. But as you can build up your supplies, I think that you'll have a more peace of mind, comfort, and you won't have a situation where you're panicked. You're out of laundry detergent because you keep your laundry detergent up to the very last day that you've got a stock that you can rotate to. Things like that. All right, guys, take care.